spelling out this little one's name.
We just thought we'd go for simplicity, as, you know, Clarke with an E causes all sorts of trouble and Jacinda with a D, so we've gone just with N-E-V-E.
Neve te aroha, Ardern Gayford, sleeping through her first media conference.
It means bright and radiant and snow, which seemed like a good combination for Matariki and for solstice.
Irish in origin, Neve's rarely seen here, according to a Christchurch baby name blogger.
Last and only time it's ever been seen since 1954 was in 2000, where it sat at 94. So it's the only time it's ever featured in the top 100, yeah.
But this high-profile baby could change that.
It's quite beautiful. It does have that kind of popular feel to it, so yeah, definitely, I do think it could catch on.
Many tribes gifted the Prime Minister te reo names, but the proud parents settled on te aroha, which means love, but also charity, compassion and empathy.
Hey, I thought, how do I reflect the generosity, particularly from all of the iwi who gifted us names? And te aroha seemed to me to be a way that we could show that love and generosity.
And in some ways, it's the Prime Minister's gift to us, to Māoridom and to our language by taking this name.
Te aroha also a nod to the town where Jacinda Ardern hails from and the mountain she grew up under. Waikato locals fizzing today.
Beautiful, beautiful. It means love. So, yeah, te aroha will be happy with that.
Absolutely great. At least we're represented in the Prime Minister's office.
Over the next 6 weeks, we'll do what every other parent does and learn the little nuances of the way that Neve wants to work.
New family life just getting underway. Yvonne Tahana, One News.